Welcome to Raw Startup. Today I'm going to show you what to do if you have an idea for an app and take it from the idea to building an actual app. Every week I get messages from people that have ideas for apps, and I get a lot of them. I get some good ones, I get some mediocre ones, I get some really, really bad ones. I try and help people move on and sort of get to from the idea to actually building an app. And this video is about what to do if you have an idea and take it to an actual app. Just to be clear, this is not a video about programming. This is a video about taking the idea from your head onto something, on a piece of paper, to really communicate what the idea is. Here's what you're gonna get from this video. First of all, we're gonna do a sanity check, just to check if this is an idea worth pursuing. Secondly, I'm gonna show you some tools on how to take the idea onto a piece of paper so you actually know what you're gonna build. And lastly, I'm gonna tell you what the next steps are to actually build an app. First of all, ideas are just ideas. They don't have any real value till you actually build something. Always remember that investors don't invest in ideas. You have to build something before it has any value. Ask yourself the following three questions. Number one, is there a problem that needs to be solved? Number two, can you actually build an app that solves the problem? And number three, is the problem frequent enough for enough people? You need a pretty clear yes on all three of these, especially if you've never built a piece of software or an app before. This is Raw Startup, so you have to be brutally honest with yourself here. Really be devil's advocate, because what we're doing now, we're avoiding a major failure. So try and be honest. Really don't try and argue for this app. Just be devil's advocate and find out, is this really something that makes sense? Let's try this with Vivino. Number one, yes, there is definitely a need for this. A lot of people have this problem. So yeah, there's definitely a need for it. Number two on Vivino was a little bit of a maybe. We actually weren't sure we could build this. That was a big gamble for us. Are we able to build the data? Are we able to build the reviews and ratings and so on? Now, 8 years later, we have 100 million ratings, so we definitely got it. But that was a gamble for us. Number three, is it the problem frequent enough for enough people? Definitely, people are in the supermarket looking for wine and can't really figure out what to buy. Everybody has this problem. They have it frequently, maybe every day or every week or whatever. Step two, do a mock-up of the app. We're still at basic computer skills here, so anyone who knows how to use Word or generally a computer can actually do this. I use a tool called Balsamiq. There are a lot of different mock-up tools out there. I like this tool, I've used it for many years, but I'm sure there are other good tools out there. It's a free tool, so you can just download it and try it out. With Balsamiq, you can easily drag and drop buttons, screens, whatever you want to do. So you can just start building. The cool thing about Balsamiq is that it shows what you want to build. It doesn't have any sort of designs. You don't make those decisions yet. Just shows a mock-up of what you want to build. So generally, you know, start by building one screen, find out what the most important screen of the app is, build that and take it from there. You can build multiple screens if you really want to show more of the app, how it's going to work and so on. You can even link things together, so you can do clickable buttons and so on. Not needed, but that's something you could do. Now let me introduce you to a concept that I think is very, very important in building any sort of software. It's called minimal viable product. It means that whatever you build the smallest possible thing every single time. So as the word says, minimal, but still viable. So I recommend anyone who builds software always to live by that philosophy. Try and build the smallest possible thing and then take it from there. This should really be the philosophy when you design software or an app, doesn't matter. Minimum viable product. Only put features in there that you really need. No nice to have features, only need to have features. So go ahead and start building. It's your idea. You decide where the buttons are, what buttons are in there. Just go ahead. Always remember, minimum viable product. Only the features you really, really need. Small as possible in the first version. Very, very important. Step three, next steps. How to build an actual app. This can go in different directions, but if you're a non-technical person, you need to find a co-founder. That's clearly my recommendation. Find a technical co-founder, somebody who understands the tech part of building an app. He or she doesn't have to be a programmer, that helps, but someone who understands what it takes to build a product, a software product. There are other ways to do this. You could pay somebody to build your app. I generally don't recommend that. It's really, really difficult to have a partner to build your idea that you actually pay to do so. They just have a different interest, and I've rarely seen this work, honestly. So that is not something I recommend. Another way to go is to use an outsourcing website and find a freelancer that can build the app for you. Someone in a faraway land that can build it for a low cost. This is also difficult, but it can be done. We've done it before. It takes a bit of management, and it takes a lot of discipline to get it right, but it can be done. This video has come to an end. And if you've succeeded in really following these three steps and built mockups of your app, please let us know. We definitely want to follow up with another video and tell you what next steps are after this. So send us a comment on YouTube or a message somewhere else, and we will follow up with another video. So good luck on building. This has been Raw Startup. Thank you very much for watching.